It is quite common for a water agency to specify a criterion to limit the amount of head loss. However, not all pipelines have the same diameter and length, if I can be Captain Obvious for a moment. And this means that if you simply look at the amount of energy loss due to friction over the length of an entire pipeline, it is very unlikely that it will be equal to any other pipeline. The term unit head loss is used to help us compare pipes of different diameters and lengths. Unit head loss is the amount of energy head loss per 1,000 length of pipe, whether measured in feet or meters. To distinguish it from the total head loss in a pipeline over a specific length L, I use the symbol H of F. Starting with the original Hazen-Williams equation, we can substitute in continuity, then convert the units of Q to GPM. And we set area and hydraulic radius in terms of the diameter and convert the diameter into inches. Then insert feet per 1,000 feet for the friction slope. I've covered the derivation of this form of the equation in another video, so I'll just mention here the unit head loss is equal to, open parentheses, 148 times Q divided by the roughness coefficient C times D to the 2.63 power, close parentheses, to the 1.85 power. Remember that the result of this equation has units of feet per 1,000 feet. Let's say we have a flow rate of 3,000 gallons per minute in a 16-inch PVC pipe with a C value of 130. Calculate the unit head loss by inserting the given information into the modified Hazen-Williams equation, and we calculate the answer to be 4.77 feet per 1,000 feet. This modified form of the Hazen-Williams is especially helpful when sizing pipelines based upon a given head loss criteria. The unit head loss criterion for a typical water system varies between 3 and 10 feet per 1,000 feet. The wide range is a function of the performance of a system under maximum day, peak hour, or max day plus fire flow conditions, as well as simply the prerogative of the specific agency. If we take the modified form of the Hazen-Williams equation and then solve for D, we get the following expression for the minimum diameter required to meet the unit head loss criterion. Let's suppose we have the same 3,000 gallon per minute flow rate, but this time, we don't know the pipe diameter. All we know is that we want to use the steel pipe that has a C value of 120. Our new pipe cannot exceed 3.5 feet per 1,000 feet. Plugging in our given values into the equation, we can determine that the minimum diameter is 17.58 inches, which we then round up to 18 inches, the next standard diameter size.